Science, Calvin Smith here, and welcome to Creation Basics, where our goal is to make God's creation part of your everyday conversation. Today's topic is a brief history of the idea of ape-men, and this is part three of three that I'm titling, What About Lucy? If you haven't seen the other two, check them out. So, Australopithecus afarensis, popularly known as Lucy, is still likely the most well-known modern example of supposed human evolution today. She was once much touted as our supposed human ancestor and was uniquely named because the Beatles song Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds was playing when she was brought together by the team that had found her in Ethiopia. However, her star has faded somewhat as more has been revealed about her to the public. For example, one of the main reasons evolution believers suggested that Lucy walked on 2 feet instead of on all fours, like the ape she resembles, is based on a set of fossilized human-looking footprints they found located in a rock layer they believe formed at the time that Lucy lived, but dated as older than they believe human beings existed. They then concluded that these footprints must have come from Lucy's kind, hence giving her museum reconstructions human-looking feet. However, they found these Latoli tracks a full 932 miles, that's 1,500 kilometers away from Lucy's bones in the country of Tanzania. So a better explanation is that their evolutionary assumptions are wrong and that they're simply a set of human footprints that have zero to do with the cobbled together bones called Lucy that aren't necessarily even collected from the same creature. You see, many laypersons likely imagine that specimens like Lucy were somehow found in a heap and carefully retrieved as a somewhat articulated skeleton that clearly show these ape-like hominids in a similar form to how their reconstructions are shown in books and in museum replicas. However, surprising to most, the bones that make up Lucy's skeleton were found scattered over an area of about 1.5 square miles. That's 2.4 square kilometers. As a matter of fact, her skeleton's only 40% complete. Kind of makes you wonder if she was not only the first missing link, but the world's first suicide bomber. You know, a clue as to how difficult her reconstruction might be, given how far-flung her bone bits were found, is in a 2015 New Scientist article where it reported this. A careful look at the ancient hominin skeleton suggests one of the bones may actually belong to a baboon. Now, statues portraying Lucy in museums to this day display her walking upright with human-like hands and feet. However, when Lucy was found, she never had hands or feet. These depictions were completely assumed based off of the footprints found 15,000 kilometers away, with no other physical evidence whatsoever. And scientists have since found other, more complete skeletons of such australopithecines, which do include hand and feet bones. And from them, we can make a pretty safe guess that Lucy's hands had long curved fingers suited for climbing in trees, and that Lucy's feet had opposable toes seen in the hand-like feet of apes that could easily grab and allow her to be a good climber. She didn't have human-like feet. And detailed studies of the inner ears, skulls, and bones suggest that Lucy and her kind were not in fact on the way to becoming human anytime soon. They may have walked more upright than most apes, but not like humans. You see, once all of the evolutionary ideologies and interpretations are stripped away, Australopithecus afarensis is very similar to what we would simply call a pygmy chimpanzee. Now, I hope you've enjoyed this series discussing a brief history of so-called ape-men that evolutionists have used to convince many people to believe the story of evolution, even many within the church. What naturalists have done is to look for the most human-looking ape fossils they can, or conversely, the most ape-like human fossils possible, and declare them as missing links. But the fact is, Darwin's missing links are still missing because they've never existed. Men were specially created in the image of God. However, belief in deceptive evolutionary ideas have led many people to conclude the God of the Bible doesn't exist, to the great detriment of mankind. But if we start with the Bible, with the historical record of the universe that God gave us, we get a different perspective. The Bible says that God created apes and humans as distinct kinds on day 6 of creation week about 6,000 years ago, which is not a problem for an all all-powerful God. If you're appreciating this content, visit the answersingenesis.ca website for much more. Please consider donating to the ministry, and whatever platform you're accessing this on, it likely has some combination of features that allow you to subscribe or like or share, and we'd appreciate you taking the time to do so because it's probably the best thing you can do to help us continue to do outreach. Until next time, I'm Cal Smith. Blessings to you.